the screen is visible, right? Yeah, we'll just open this schematics. So the shortcut you might have saved somewhere, open it. Otherwise, if you open PSpice, you have to open the schematics only. Be careful with it. And there only you can able to draw the circuit. So go to draw, then get new component. Yeah, go to draw, get new part. So what are all the parts here? What is the circuit? You can just place it right to you so that it will be helpful. So you always use your observation copy, don't refer to the soft copy. Okay, so here what are all the things we need? Here is the op amp, capacitor, resistor, this RC circuit, this feedback we require two resistors. This is how we are going to do it. So op amp MUA741, you can just type the part name over here. Mu, you can type it as U, okay, UA741. But while writing, you have to write it MUA741, okay, be careful with it. So then resistors are required, just type with R, you can get the resistor. So how many resistors we require? Total together 3. Just place it appropriately where you require it. So then if you don't want this anymore, you can press right click or you can press escape, anything is fine. Then I require a capacitor, I'll just type with C and I'll place a capacitor. So that's it. Then if you just refer into the diagram, you'll come to know you need ground and this DC power supply. So VDC and ground. So you have used ground here so many locations, right? Almost 4. So just go to ground. So for that ground, you can just type it with ground earth, GND earth, you can type it. So here it is. I'll just place this. So I require one in the feedback, require one for this RC circuit, require it for this biasing voltage. So 4 grounds are placed. I'll just click on right click. Then I require VDC. So VDC, just place it. So here it is little complex. Now I'll just place it a little far. Later I'll just arrange this. So only so many components. Then now I'll close this. So you can just place it little down. You can also reverse, tilt, many things you can do it. So first let me connect the power supply, this VDC, because it is little complex here. I need VDC, I need wires in between, ground, all those things. Now the terminal 7 should be connected to positive terminal, negative terminal should be connected to the ground here. So I'll just rotate this component. So select that, press Ctrl R, you can rotate. If I want negative terminal to be connected here, then I can just click again. So I'll get negative terminal. Be careful when you're doing this. So I need to connect positive terminal to 7. So I'll just place it somewhere here. Never connect end to end like this. You get a warnings. And also your output will not be correct. Okay, be careful with this. But one thing you need to remember, whenever you are doing the real hardware, so try to connect end to end all the components in order to avoid the drop. So when you are doing software, try to have wire always in between the components. Okay, you'll get a wire here. So click on these. So connect this wire and connect this. It's done. Now I'll connect this battery, rotate this. So negative of the voltage supply has to be connected to the terminal 4. So I'll place it here. The ground, I'll place it here. So connect these things. So now you've just done the basic connections of biasing voltage for the op amp. So now we need to do the circuit connections. So what's the circuit connection now? Just I did only so much. So this capacitor and resistor to be connected together, and this junction should be go to terminal 2. Terminal 2 is here. So this need to do these connections and connect it to this point. Then terminal 3 with this. Circuit is very simple. But you need to know the working of it. It is very important and essential as well. So use the wire, connect these components. Be careful, you should get a bubble on this. Only then it indicates there is a connectivity between this line and this line. Now output has to be connected with this. Then this output has to be connected for this feedback resistor. So in between this, we need to connect it for 3. So now the complete circuit has been done now. You can look into this. So now the circuit is ready. But the thing is, you need to provide the values. By default, whenever I used, I get 0 voltage here. I get 1 nanofarads here. 1 kilo ohm resistor here. But as per the design, you can use what is the values you require. So the capacitor value we are using 1 microfarads. So RC circuit resistor value 1.33 kilo ohms. So this is 1 microfarad. So micro, just click on this value. Instead of N, I just make it U. So here 1.33 kilo ohms. K is already there, I just make it. Sorry. See, now your R2 is 10 kilo ohms, R1 is 2.2 kilo ohms. R1 is the one which has been connected with the R1 is the one which has been connected with the ground. So 2.2, here it is 10. So here it is 2.2 kilo ohms. Already K is there. Here it is 10. So now you have done with all resistors, capacitors. But what is this biasing voltage? We'll give it 12 volts. So click on this value, make it 12 volts. So it is positive voltage which has been connected for terminal 7. So just make it 12 volts there. So positive terminal has been connected. It becomes positive 12 volts. The negative terminal is connected to 4. Just make it 12 volts. Don't make it minus 12. It will lead into error. Okay. Just 12 volts. But negative terminal has been connected to this pin number 4. 6 is your output terminal. Now the circuit connection is done. So you have to save this. So go to file, save. I'll just save it in a, you just create one drive, save it inside that. Okay, I'll just save it inside this ADE. I'll save it as relaxation oscillator. Otherwise I'll just create a folder. So lab experiment, inside this I'll just create it for relaxation oscillator. That's fine. So I just saved this file. Now I need to simulate this. Before I simulate, I'm not providing any inputs for this. So what is the important thing now? How I'm going to execute this? What is the frequency I've designed? If you look into the things, details, right? What frequency we have designed? We have designed it for 1 kilohertz frequency. 1 kilohertz frequency, one time, total time is 1 millisecond. So whenever we do the settings, right? How many pulses you want to display? You have to go to this setup analysis, enable the transient, click on the transient, provide this final time. This is to design your output screen. So I want to display 4 pulses. Suppose then 4 milliseconds you have to give it. I want to display 10 pulses, then 10 milliseconds. So it's all depends on your requirement, what you need to display. I'll just display 5 pulses, so I've given 5 milliseconds. Print step, even if it is 0 nanoseconds, no issues. Otherwise, if you want, you can make it 0 milliseconds. One thing you should remember, initially the charging across the capacitor was 0. So it takes some time to charge and discharge, only then it can start oscillating. So what I do is, I'll just enable this skip initial transient solution. I don't want let the capacitor starts from a zero charge and then later gradually it's working. So I'll just enable this skip initial transient solution, then click on OK and close this. So this is what the settings you do it. Now you can able to simulate this. Any doubts in these things? So there is some error in it. Yeah, we have not marked what we need to measure, where we need to measure. So that's the reason we are not able to get any output over there. So what we need to measure as per our circuit? So we need to measure the voltage across terminal 2 and we need to measure our output. Voltage across terminal 2 is the VC voltage and our output voltage we need to measure. So place the voltage marker, click on this, place it across the VC and across the output and also label it. Click, double click on this bubble, label this, I'll label this as VC and I'll label this as Vout. Yes, just click on save and then simulate it. So we got this output. So you can measure these values, how much you're getting. How to measure that? Go to this, say this red color one is the VC, voltage across the capacitor. This green color one is the V out, voltage across the output terminal. How much voltage here it is? You can just go to this toggle cursor. Just place the cursor there and you can mark this. So here it is. How much you can measure here? So 11.614 is the voltage across this. The first one is the X value, this time, time in milliseconds, voltage in volts, this Y axis in volts. So this is 11.614 you're getting. So it should be 90% of the 12 volts what we have connected here. So approximately we are getting that. But how much we have to get across this VC? VC is beta into so this feedback factor beta R1 divided by R1 plus R2. So when we want to measure this voltage across this capacitor, how much it should be? Whenever these both are equal, then it's making our output to zero. When this voltage VC and the terminal 2 voltage is equal, it's making our output to fall down to 0. So at this point we are measuring. Yeah, here. Yeah. So feedback factor is beta here, R1 divided by R1 plus R2 into this V out. V out, how much it was, you just calculate that. Okay. So V out here is 11.614 into beta. That is what you're going to get it at this particular time duration. Because here it was the same. Then once both are equal, then it becomes to zero. Again here, so in the negative side, almost you're getting 11.613. So 11.613 into beta. You calculate, that is will be your VC. You can measure this VC as well. So just Yeah, you choose this PC, then you place the cursor on this and mark that VC. So VC here 2.1784 is the VC. And what we need to measure here is we have designed it for 1 kilohertz frequency. You have to measure whether you are getting 1 kilohertz frequency. How can we measure frequency in this waveform? So we can measure the time. So the time, total time taken for 1 cycle. So I'll not be considering the first cycle because it has been skipped. So I'll just consider the second cycle onwards. So I'll just use this toggle cursor. I'll place it. Otherwise, I'll just mark this. That is also fine. Yeah. So at this particular time, so you just concentrate for your X 1.906. Okay, you can mark this as well. So 1.906. So this negative cycle and then one positive cycle. Again, here you just mark it. It is 2.97. So 2.97 minus 1.906. So approximately you are getting 1.01 or 0 something you are getting. So it is almost 1 millisecond. When you convert that to frequency, 1 divided by 1.0, what is the value here? I think 1.07. So 1 divided by 1.07, you'll be getting approximately 1 kilohertz frequency. So now this circuit is working perfectly correct. So is this clear? So this is what the working of the